New today, a Texas judge handing a narrow legal victory to abortion rights activists just days after the state's restrictive abortion law went into effect. Late Friday, the judge granted a restraining order against the state's largest anti-abortion group, blocking it from suing abortion providers employed by Planned Parenthood. And joining me now is Cynthia Oxney, MSNBC legal analyst and former federal prosecutor. Cynthia, let's get into this right away here. What does the new state judge's ruling mean in the big picture grand scheme of things?
Nothing. I mean, let me just tell you what. The Supreme Court of the United States is effectively overturning Roe v. Wade. And one state court judge in Austin, which is this little island of liberalism, is not going to change the reality on the ground, which is there is effectively not abortion options for women in Texas. And the Supreme Court, in a one-paragraph opinion, have overruled 48 years of precedent, and without even bothering to mention Roe v. Wade in their unsigned opinion and their shadow docket. Mm-hmm. The whole thing is outrageous. And the idea that one little judge in the island of Austin in the middle of Texas is going to change that Supreme Court reality is ridiculous. It's of no moment.
So this shadow docket I find absolutely fascinating. I know there are times when a shadow docket is required, but in this case, given the high-profile nature of it, the passions around it, it is extraordinary that the only ones to write about their reasonings for opposing it were the three liberal justices, as well as the Chief Justice, John Roberts, who said, right. I don't agree. What happened there?
It's sneaky. That's what it is. We just have to call it what it is. They want to overturn Roe v. Wade. They can't wait to do it until the Mississippi case comes up. And they want to get it done. And they've done it in this backdoor way. It's outrageous. But let me tell you what. We've had 48 years to get the legislative protection for women done in the Congress, and they haven't done it. And this, I hope, is the impetus for them to actually do what they need to do. They need to have this vote, and they need to vote over and over and over and over again until everybody's on the record and there is a federal right to control your own body.
Okay, so to that end, you know, they voted not to block this bill, but the Supreme Court is likely going to have to review the merits of this law if more challenges are brought against it. Is this week an indicator of what the final decision will be?
Yes. Yes. Yes, it is. They overruled 48 years of precedent and didn't even bother to mention that that's what they were doing. They clearly have been saying, the Republicans have been saying for almost 50 years, we're going to do this. Wait, hang on a second. Do you think to overturn Roe v. Wade?
So look, Roe v. Wade in its entirety, or are they going to take a piecemeal approach to doing it? Which is the more likely?
You know what? I used to think that they were going to do it sort of quietly, sneakily, back to the states, try to say it's all procedure. But this is so brazen that my guess would be when the Mississippi case comes, they just overrule Roe v. Wade. And let me tell you what, if they overrule Roe v. Wade, there are 11 states in this country that say the minute Roe v. Wade is sent to the states, it's illegal in our state. I mean, we are months away from women all over the South not having an option. And you know what that means? That means rich women, my kids, that means rich women have an option because they can just fly to California or they can fly to New York or Massachusetts. But poor women have no options. And these people don't care at all. And if you ever wonder about that, read the dissenting opinion of Kavanaugh in that abortion case that came up to him when he was a federal district judge. No empathy for poor people. And they're trying to overrule Roe v. Wade, and they have effectively done it in Texas, and they are going to do it in this country. And so everybody better call their congressperson, and they better get themselves on the move to get a federal law, because otherwise, poor women have no choices.
This is going to ignite something extraordinarily polarizing. We have not seen
as
the likes
of it. As it should, given to what they're doing to us.
Cynthia Oxney, thank you so much for weighing in. Appreciate that.